Energy CS Davis Chirchir and former Kenya National Examination Council CEO Paul Wasanga today appeared before anti-corruption investigators at Integrity Center as the inquest continues into election materials and exam papers tendering process scandal christened the Chicken Gate. Former NEC boss Paul Wasanga emerged after 4 hours of grilling and denied allegations that he received a bribe in 2010 from Smith and Osman printing firm directors to influence the exam certificates printing tender.
The Corruption and Corruption Commission is investigating to find out whether those allegations are correct or not. No, I'm not involved.
Wasanga insists that the firm won the tender through competitive bidding.
We have 9 other printers which are qualified, but the awarding of the tenders for Smith has been above board, where they have been, it's only that they, in the times when they are printed examination, they have won the tender. And not that they were given free, they have won the tender.
Energy CS Davis Chirchir, who previously served at the electoral body, also maintained his innocence.
I've answered the questions that has been put to me, and I want to confirm to you that I've had a very nice interview, something that I've longed for, to basically be able to articulate the issues I know and the issues I don't know.
Chirchir called on anyone with information about the scandal to present it to the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission, EACC.
But to the extent that we must fight corruption, it is important that we encourage anybody with evidence to really bring forward, so that on any case, including this one, so that the case can be conclusively finished and we can move on to address issues affecting our economy, from unemployment, all those issues of insecurity.
Former IEBC CEO James Oswago is expected to appear before the anti-graft body next week. The Chicken Gate scandal has already seen 2 people jailed in the United Kingdom. Nicholas Smith and his father Christopher of Smith and Osman Printing Firm were found guilty of bribing officials of the then Interim Independent Electoral Commission, IIEC. The Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission is heavily relying on evidence from a UK court to prosecute IEBC officials allegedly involved in the scandal. Yesterday, Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission Chair Isaac Hassan exonerated himself from the scandal and called for a fair trial of those implicated.
For the second day in running, officers drawn from the EACC have been questioning former IIEC officials in regards to the multi-million chicken scandal. But still, many questions remain unanswered. For Channel One News Hour, I'm Roncliffe Odit.